Sanchez, naga rin. And even in Luzon, in CR areas, yung mga dining in sa restaurants, pinagbabawal na rin. So, instead of us embracing the new normal, this is the part of the new normal, we still embed on the new normal, yung pag-iingat pa rin. Tumataas ng tumataas yung incidence of COVID. Yung mga offices ay nagkakaroon na rin ng mga infections. At necessary orders are in place at mga sanitation should be done. So very timely pa rin itong discussion natin ngayon. And as I have said, our online program is an online platform wherein we cater discussions in yung kapihan par issues and concerns about revenue generations about our treasurers and assessors. We also discuss straight directly issues and concerns raised in our comment section from the field. Galing sa inyo kung ano man yung mga katanungan nyo, ipopost niyo yung comment niyan. But as of now, wala tayong issues and concerns na ni-raise coming from the field, coming from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. So again, we will be breaking off with our regular programming. And we will continue to know better yung mga nominees natin for outstanding and inspiring treasurers and assessors in Central Visayas. Last episode, nakilala natin yung apat nating mga nominees. Through video presentations, mas nakilala nyo ng maigi yung mga performance nila sa kanilang LGUs. This time, ladies and gentlemen, we have 4 additional nominees kung saan we will talk intimately, one-on-one, parang heart-to-heart talk para mas makilala nyo sila if they deserve your heart react, if they deserve your vote. Again, ladies and gentlemen, we are live stream sa ating Facebook page, official Facebook page ng BLGF7. Mamaya, ibibigay ng ating production team yung statistics of how far we have reached and how far our engagements are. Last week, I have said 174,000 na yung engagement natin. Ngayon, this week, alamin natin yan. But ladies and gentlemen, let us first hear a message and look first. Itong nag-brainchild ng ating search for most outstanding treasures and assessors. And by far, during our first episode where we know better yung mga 4 nominees, mas nakilala pala natin yung trabaho ng treasurers and assessors. Yun yung feedback namin na narinig namin sa aming director. Ardi, good morning, Director Jesse Diaktolero. Ito yung feedback natin kung first episode kung saan nakilala natin yung 4 nominees, Ardi. Parang napaka-positive ng feedback coming from the field, Ardi.
Yes, sir. Before that, I would like to greet our finalists who are with us in the Zoom room. So, good morning everyone. And of course, sa ato mga regular viewers, mga assessors, mga treasurers sa Central Visayas, and to the entire Philippines, the entire nation as well. So, good morning po. Again, just like yung sinabi ni Attorney, we'll do away with the regular programming of the online kapihan, consulta kay Attorney Tanika, to give way for our interview with our finalists for the search for the most inspiring treasurer and assessor in Central Visayas. So, just like yung feedback from our 4 finalists last week, we achieve our purpose. So, maraming nagsasabi, maraming nagte-text sa akin, sabi, RD, nakaka-inspire naman pala ng mga treasurers nyo dyan sa Central Visayas.
Yeah.
Sabi nila, na-appreciate nila yung trabaho pala ng isang treasurer, ng mga assessor. So it's not all about the treasury per se na trabaho, but beyond the call of duty that our treasurers and assessors has been performing despite the pandemic. So at least once we have realized na na-inspire natin yung ibang treasurer. Sabi nila, kagandaman na at least na nakita yung value ng mga treasurers and assessors natin. So with that note, so sana ma-achieve din natin with this group of finalists for this morning, Torns.
Yes. Okay. Thank you for that, Ardy. That was our regional director, Director JC, Dr. Larry, who will be joining us later para naman sa ating mga exclusive one-on-one banter sa ating mga treasurers at assessors na ating kikilalanin mamaya-maya. Ayan. So here we go. Kikilalanin na natin ng mas maigi. We got to know them better now. Wala namang pinagbabawal sa mag-heart react ka na 3 times, 4 times. If you like these 4 interviews, nominees that we have. Heart react sa 4 na nominees natin ngayon. Miski naka-heart react na kayo sa previous nominees. So, nga, sabi ng ating regional director, inadvertently, although we are searching for the most outstanding and inspiring treasurers amidst pandemic, inadvertently, ipakita na rin natin sa public, sa ating viewing public, na this is not that easy yung trabaho ng ating treasurers at assessors. So, very inspiring indeed yung mga ginagawa ating treasurers at assessors. Okay. In the meantime, bago natin i-introduce yung first nominee natin, papasadahan muna natin yung mga early bird watchers, streamers natin sa ating Facebook page live. Ilan na kaya yung mga naka-FB page live? With that, ladies and gentlemen, bumalik yung yung bumabatang co-host ko. Alam niyo na kung sino? Yeah, hanggang ngayon, hindi pa na-reveal kung ano yung secret. Ladies and gentlemen, ang chief ng ating Treasury Division, looking healthy, and yet, patuloy pa rin pabata ng pabata. Miss Jonah Naberia, Nay. Good morning, Nay. Shout out naman dyan.
Good morning, everybody. I miss you. Ha? Ilang sessions ang hindi tayo nagkita. Pero ito lang paalala, ha? Mas hugas iwas para maiwasan si COVID. Okay. So far we have 78 live viewers na, attorney.
Okay.
At saka parang padami na ng padami ang mga top fan natin. Ha?
Yung paulit-ulit nag-comment at saka nag-view.
Dami na nila pagkatapos hindi talaga sila nagsasawa na na makinig at manood sa ating episode. So, shout out to Maria Ceres Yas, bagong top fan, kay Charito ng Dumanhog, Lucila Sapepe, Julie Santos ng LGU, Benito Sullivan. Isa pa rin siyang top fan.
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning.
Si Bersilia Soriano Kidato, si Handayan Linlin ng Maso Kandihay, Glenn Bear de la Pina, Bernadette Tobalia Obanyana, Maria Adeli Herrera Idaño, Marilo Herrera, Zenny de Borja, Lucel Vios Orlina, Heidi Macapobre Corbo ng Toledo City, si Yarim, Stella, Andrew Perez ng Giholngan City, and Leticia Cabilo ng Dumanhog. And i-plug ko, please nire-remind ko mga ESRE champions. Ha, pag malapit na ang ating deadline, don't wait for the deadline to upload your report kasi traffic na. Please. Okay.
Yung server magta-traffic na. Thank you for that, Miss Jonah Nabelia. Standby ka lang dyan. Minsan na, paki-remind rin. Minsan din kasi nahiyang mag-comment yung mga attendees natin. So, paki-basa na rin yung mga nag-like at saka mag-heart react. Mahiyain lang yan, hindi magko-comment. So, paki-basa na rin yung mga viewers natin na nag-like lang at saka nag-heart react. I'll get back to you, Miss Jonah Nabelia. Ayan, remind ko lang uli ha. Huwag kayong maghiyang magtanong pa rin. Mahiyang magtanong. Miski we are breaking off with our regular programming, pwede pa rin kayong mag-raise ng question dyan sa comment section. And I'm sure we can find time, not in this episode kasi baka gagahulin tayo ng oras, in some other episode and in some future discussion. So comment at saka raise pa rin ng questions nyo dyan. And this is it for our first nominee. Kikilalanin na natin ang ating first nominee coming from Cebu Province, representing assessment group, the municipality level. Reactions team, stand by for the video introduction of our first nominee.
Municipal Assessor of LGU Consolacion Cebu. It is with deep humility that I render the major challenges, highlights, and accomplishments of the Municipal Assessor during the pandemic year 2020. Starting January 20, 2020 up to August 12, 2020, in compliance to Cebu Sangguniang Panlalawigan Ordinance No. 2019-17, enacted on December 26, 2019, this is an exemplary innovation because due to very limited resources, hardware and humanware, we adopted two shifts work scheme. This is a value-added sacrifice of the assessor's office and was able to submit the books of revised tax declarations to the province as first five compliant LGU. LGU Assessor's Office, in compliance to Cebu Provincial Memorandum dated May 2020, we conducted an inventory of idle lands in the barangays and submitted to the province on the third week of May, which aimed to identify idle lands for the purpose of providing seedlings to lot owners. Municipal Assessor was assigned as team leader of Barangay Nangka SAP Distribution Group and in hand released 3,200 cash envelopes to SAP beneficiaries, senior citizens, UCT, PWD, BHW, TANODs, and others. As team leader in the repackers of goods, we packed four waves of goods with 40,000 packs each wave or batch to our townspeople. The Municipal Assessor spearheaded the awarding of our four centenarians. Those were the 100-year-old Fox last year. Two top business taxpayers awardees, six pioneering companies in the town, and posthumous recognition to all our town mayors serving since the townhood in 1920 up to 2019 for being instrumental in making Consolacion what it is today. Being an LGU regular project, the Municipal Assessor as co-chairman of the mayor of the Municipal Puro Coordinating Committee, we planned and implemented the search for the best Puruk in two categories, the urban and the rural barangays, led the appreciation visits to these 21 barangays with evaluation team. In accordance to Republic Act 10023, otherwise known as Residential Free Patent Act, and DNR LGU signed Memorandum of Partnership Agreement, the Municipal Assessor continued the program in Barangay Hugan, where a total of 78 qualified patent applications were processed and endorsed to CENRO for the year 2020. This is considered an exemplary effort of the assessor or land management officer to help tax declarants acquire patents to their lands and make an economic rebound to help themselves economically at this time of pandemic.
We have already the different sections, different functions undertaken by the office because that's a regular LGU office and we only have two regular staff. I have 11 job order workers and I have two on-the-job trainees. So with this very limited resource, human resource, I would say, wow, this is an additional load because many times we have been other tasks given to us like in the awarding for foundation anniversary or during fiesta, nightly features or so. We have been given additional workload. But this one, being an additional section in your office, with the same number of personnel, very, very limited human resource, but we will have to make do with what we have and do our best. And I think it's all in time management, it's all in coordination, it's all in working together and giving incentives to your men, to your staff, to get the services across. And after all, public service is not profit-oriented. This is for our people. So we'll have to work hard to leave a legacy.
A great day to all. LGU Consolation, Assessor staff, request you to hard react to Madam Herrera. A vote for her is an honor for Consolation and love for Cebu province. Mabuhi ka, Subuanon!
Yeah! Hi, good morning! Ladies and gentlemen, our first nominee representing Cebu province, the Assessment Group Municipality Level, Miss Malu Herrera! Good morning, Ma'am Malu!
Greetings of a fine morning to one and all. This is from the LGU of Consolacion Cebu, a first-class municipality in Cebu province, tagged as the gateway to the north, headed by Dr. Joy Joy Alegado.
Ayan! Ma'am, you are very active din as the leader of the Association of Cebu Municipal Assessors Group. Madalas pa ba rin yung mga meetings natin with the Municipal Assessors of Cebu, ma'am?
Online platform na lang, attorney, once a month.
But very cohesive rin yung group natin. Okay.
Yes, yes, attorney.
Now let's go. Na-amaze ako dun, ma'am. Kasi nga, I recall it right. We were preparing the updating of the schedule of matinito sa doon sa province, doon sa capital 2019. At gustong-gusto na ni Gov na i-effect na yung collection as to 2020. And yet, we have to conduct general revision pa rin. Dumating yung pandemic. How was that affected yung general revision, conduct of your general revision, ma'am? How was it affected by the pandemic, ma'am?
It has slowed down, surely, attorney. But with a mechanism in place, I had two work shifts. We are the only office in the province of Cebu that opens the office at 5 in the morning until 9:30 in the evening, Monday to Saturday, just to effect the general revision.
Well, and you are one of the top 5 na nagkasabit ng tapos lahat, revise lahat yung records nyo sa Cebu province.
Yes,
ma'am?
Yes, with the RPUs of 49,581.
Wow, and how
one
many?
One of the biggest.
Kanina nakita ko, how many hectares ngayong Consolacion, ma'am?
Ay, maliit lang. One of the second smallest, that's 42 hectares in land area.
Again, this is soon becoming to be a city kasi ka, first class tayo, pero ang daming business activity dyan at saka mga new developments dyan. So, nahirapan ba kayo sa field activity during the lockdown, ma'am?
Yes, sir. But again, it's on the enthusiasm, it's open-mindedness, and we do this for our people. So we have to get the service across.
Now, can you elaborate more on the shifting, ma'am? Ano yung ginagawa? I understand kasi noong during lockdown at saka pandemic, ini-encourage yung mga alternative work arrangements. So can you elaborate further on that? Ano yung sinasabi mong dalawang shifting, ma'am?
Yes, we started on January 2020 before the outburst of COVID. Right? Mm-hmm. So we had two shifts. The first batch of my people, that would be 13 of my staff, reports at 5 in the morning until 1:30 in the afternoon. At 1 o'clock, the second shift starts until 9:30 in the evening. So in one computer, in one hardware, there will be two staff, morning and afternoon shifts, so we can get really our target dates.
Okay. Forgive my naivety, ma'am. Yung pagkainunan ko during, kung ano yung nangyayari during lockdown. So, ano ba yung mga transaction na usually recurring notwithstanding the pandemic, ma'am?
During the general revision, transfer transactions are suspended. So, only the regular task of certifications, issuance, certified copies, land holdings for the estate taxes computation. But for transfer transactions, instructions. Yeah. It's suspended until we are able to pass the books to the province.
Matapos. Eh, no, I understand, ma'am. There was a time na mayroong specific instruction coming from sa taas na suspended yung mga field activities. How are you going to cope up with the general revision? Is suspended yung field activities, ma'am?
It's still okay because we are in the office revising desk work on our computers, but it was in May of last year that we went out again after the work from home schedule of 3 days a week reporting. But after a couple of months, we went back to 4 days a week reporting.
You know, during lockdown and even up to now, yung ini-enforce yung mga minimum health protocols. How strict are you dyan sa office nyo, ma'am?
We are very strict.
1 to 5, from 1 na lenient hanggang sa 5 na pinaka-stricto.
We would be saying humbly at 4. Because how much we tried to enforce health protocols and with an invisible foe, the virus, some of our taxpayers, especially those lining up outside our offices, forget the government advice, especially in social distancing.
Itatanong, susundot ko rin, ma'am. Sabi mo, for yung rating. So how do you enforce social distancing nga doon sa clientele mo? Yung nga ganyan,
We usually would have the tarpaulin and the reminders on our walls, on our office doors. Reminding them, and we have microphone, so we will be reminding taxpayers, please keep the 1 meter distance and please stick to your seats. Do not roam around.
Aside from yung mga actual physical transaction, have you introduced other alternative ways to transact with your clientele, Mamalo?
Yes, sir. For alternative ways, we have the clients would transact in 2 windows at the taxpayer's lounge. That's for simple transactions. Okay. While a drop box is provided for transfer transactions and feedbacking the following morning. We also entertain consultations via cell phone, telephone, and Facebook, and inquiries are answered too.
So this shows that notwithstanding the pandemic, tuloy-tuloy yung reservisyo ni Ms. Malo Herrera at saka ng Municipal Assessor's Office of Consolation. Now, what the practices? Alam ko, busy-busy pa rin yung assessor notwithstanding the pandemic and observing the health protocols, of course. What practices have you introduced na wala noong una, before the pandemic, eh ngayon, naaroon na to prevent or to mitigate COVID-19 transmission, Ma'am Malo?
In order to mitigate COVID transmission, a temperature scan and hand sanitizer are placed at the building entrance and at our office door. We installed acrylic table shields, attorney. May mga table shields na kami.
Yung parang barrier, yes. harang sa
yes,
mga table.
Yes, may harang. We have mandatory swab for all employees and job orders last year and as needed. And we provided electric fans, air purifiers, and UV rays disinfection machine to ensure proper ventilation. That would mean we shut down our air conditioning and instead we make use of electric fans. And we disinfect the office floor every day at 5 in the afternoon. And we put on the UV rays disinfection every Friday, 5 p.m.
Wow, ang dami dun. Temperature check every 5 o'clock, sanitation, mga acrylic barriers. These are parang standard of the times na yata, Ma'am Malo. This is not innovation, but nevertheless, this is a practice that kept Municipal Assessor's Office of Consolation growing, notwithstanding the pandemic. Na nakita ko kanina, ma'am, pero itatanong ko pa rin. Have been called to other extraordinary function aside from your regular function as assessor? Have you been called to participate in activities, yung mga program ng issues that responds to the COVID mitigation and prevention, ma'am?
Yes, in response to the needs of the times, SAP distribution at Barangay Nangka, I was the team leader. We distributed 3,200 envelopes to beneficiaries and even went to some homes.
Panibigay ng SAP, ma'am?
Yes, yes.
Diba ang top, parang ang crowded noon? So, were you not afraid na you are that exposed to COVID-19 during the time?
We distributed in gyms, attorney, to accommodate 600. So, what I did was, there should be an 8 to 10, 10 to 11 schedule, 1 to 3, like that. So, only a number of 80 persons that period. And they are seated far apart from each other.
Yan, tanong ko lang ma'am, during that time, eh, medyo malapit ka sa tao. Ang daming tao kasi niyan, 600 yung capacity. Hindi ka ba naka-experience minsan na natakot na baka lagnatin ako pag-uwi, baka sisipunin ako pag-uwi nito? So ano yung pananggalang mo doon ma'am na para mawala yung takot mo?
Double dosage of vitamin C, yeah. Attorney. And reminders always to our people and my team and my group in going there to and fro the area. Each one has an alcohol and we make use of gloves, especially when handling the envelopes to to clients, attorney.
Oh. Now, ito pang huli, katatakutan na question. What if... Simbako, kung sa Bisaya pa, palayo lang to. What if may magka-COVID infection talaga dyan sa office or magiging considered close contact? What are your in place na protocol dyan, ma'am? Ano yung gagawin nyo kung sakali man?
We had no case in my office last year, 2020. But if there's a suspect or those employees showing simple symptoms, the staff is advised to home quarantine and take swab test. We have 2 swab tests scheduled Tuesday and Friday. And those close contacts will have to go home too and subject to swab test. The MHO will issue certification of wellness and compliance to quarantine procedure before the staff reports back to office. And we have weekly office meeting, attorney. So reminders would be really stringent. Parang sirang plaka si madam.
Oh, yun nga, itanong ko niya rin eh. Eh, pag nakakita ka ng staff mo na nagkukumpul-kumpul sila, eh walang face mask o kumakain ng sabay-sabay, ano yung ginagawa natin, ma'am?
Ay, bawal yan, attorney. To each his own in his table. Eat your meal in your table. Oh. At saka, no, walang tanggalan ng face mask. Oh. Sinasabi ko nga, kung kakain ka, kung pwede mag-face mask ka rin. Kidding,
sorry. That is how caring Ms. Malu Herrera is and our president ng ating Association of Cebu Municipal Assessors. Now, ma'am, at this juncture, i-invite na natin sila. If you don't have anything to add, mga achievements ng ating Municipal Assessors, I now implore you to invite our viewers from the entire Philippines to heart react para mag-vote kay Ms. Malu Herrera, the Municipal Assessor of Consolacion. Go ahead, ma'am.
Thank you, attorney. I am only a simple and petite lady, but I am God's wonderful creation, like each one of you. And I can be remembered by my family name, Herrera. H stands for humane and service-oriented. Having been serving the LGU for 29 years, I'm effective because I'm a hands-on person. I am R for responsible. I assume accountability with all the tasks given me. I'm resourceful for another R. Because within the time and resources at hand, I maximize output. I'm full of energy, so energetic, with vigor and enthusiasm. R for real and genuine. And A, I'm adaptive, meaning flexible and willing to learn new ways. Warmest gratitude goes to all my kapamilya and kapuso, specifically my colleagues in the LGU and my assessor's office, who are my active REACT campaign staff, and my ACMA members. My family, a husband and 4 children with 2 children-in-laws who requested actively their high school, college classmates and office co-workers for votes and my siblings soliciting heart reacts. Mm-hmm. Lastly, I am grateful to him up there, our Almighty, for the many graces and gifts and for touching the hearts and hands of BLGF7 through RD Dr. Lero and Attorney Tanyeka, moving proactively and walk the talk in the service of our people. To God be the glory. I heart you all.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, our first nominee for today's episode, Ms. Marilu Herrera, the Municipal Assessor of Consolacion Cebu. Thank you, Ms. Marilu. RD, kakausapin ko muna si RD. You are once a provincial assessor yourself, RD. Eh, wala pa yung pandemic. Mahirap ba yung mag-revise ng records, RD?
Pinaka-challenging na trabaho ng mga assessors is the conduct of general revision.
Mas nagka-pandemic pa.
Yes, much more. if it has nagtaon sa pandemic. So I salute our finalists from Consolacion for a job well done. Congratulations.
Thank you, RD. Ayan. So ayan, that was our first nominee. So break off muna sa ating interview sa going towards our second nominee. Papasadahan muna natin yung mga comment section natin at mga pa-shoutout sa mga nanonood dyan. Remind ko lang kayo ha. Although hindi natin matakol yung mga i-consulta ngayon, yung mga queries nyo, you can still raise your queries there. Inunote ng production team dyan. Yan. At saka we'll find time to discuss your queries and concerns. Ladies and gentlemen, balikan natin yung chief ng aming Treasury Division para sa mga sigaw palabas. Shout out, Miss Yonana Bilia, pasok na eh.
Hey, sigaw palabas, sabi ni Juliet Valdez. Watching from LGU Can Avid, Eastern Samar Assessor's Office. So, Eastern Samar, ha, nakaabot tayo doon. Good morning everyone, watching from Assessor's Office of Sibunga, Cebu, from Virgilia Rufo Opone. Sabi naman ni Ma'am Marilo, good morning to all. Aluginsan is watching. Wow, Aluginsan. Daming nanonood from Aluginsan. And LGU Santo Niño Western Samar Region 8 nanonood po. Sabi naman ni Joel Allen, good morning BLGF. I-shout out mo naman si Robert Atakador Tautuan. Shout out po kay Gemma Sumalpong, kay Widnag Uliman Gonzales, Cirilo Amazuna, Christina Mons, Hernan Soriano ng Paso Masbate, Amidst Gitonis ng Santo Niño Samar, Aylen Parado ng Municipal Treasurer of Consolacion, si Rosine Montalaba ng Minglanilla Cebu, si Imelda Rivera ng Iloan, Rinihayag ng LGU Anda, Romel Judy Riosa ng Vintar Ilocos Norte, kay Esther Bagiran Hilbero, top fan ka na Esther, kay J. Marie Milihor ng ang focal ng Argao, kay Elsa Corazon Kabatbat ng Municipal Assessor's Office Daan Bantayan Cebu, the Municipal Treasurer of Bajan, Ma'am Susan Pique, she's watching, and P. Almenye, the Acting City Assessor of Tagbilaran City. Upar Torns, we have 98 live viewers na po.
Ah, thank you, Nay. RD, pasok, RD. Go ahead.
Gusto ko lang i-shout out our Deputy Executive Director, Attorney Positan, Apla Atayag, is watching with us. Thank you, Ma'am Plosig.
Good morning, Ma'am. Attorney Plosig, good morning, Ma'am. And nice of you to join us. Thank you, RD. Ayan. Good morning rin para doon kay kakilala namin dyan sa Mandawi. Nakalimutan ko kung kuan. Si good morning Mrs. Oliva, Ophelia M. Oliva. Sunday, may pagkakautang ako sa'yo. Pasensya na, hindi ako tumawag kasi takot ako sa'yo eh. Baka sasawayin mo ako. Nag-i-guess ka sana sa namin. Ma'am, we'll talk about pwede release eh, ma'am. Pag matapos namin itong mga episodes on the nominees. Kasi advocate kasi si Mrs. Oliva. Remember last time, she was invited to talk with us on Cytos of Taxation. Inabitin tayo. Yan. Good morning, Mrs. Oliva. Shout out din doon sa mga suki namin sa Sibunga, Cebu. Yung nagpunta doon sa regional office. Ayan. Let's now go on with our second nominee, ladies and gentlemen. This time representing the Treasury Group, still coming from the province of Cebu. Our second nominee will be introduced to a video presentation. Go ahead, production team.
The local government unit of San Ramejo is a third-class municipality located on the northern part of Cebu and the gateway to island of Bantayan. Famous for having the longest shoreline in the entire Cebu and the multi-awarded LGU, to mention some, the second in the overall DTI competitive index, third to fourth class municipalities, and the most prestigious award is the recipient of the Seal of God Local Governance for 3 years. When the whole country was declared on the state of emergency because of a pandemic, the COVID-19, our LGU initiated precautionary measures to control the spread of the virus. The municipal mayor issued memorandums on health protocols in consonance with the national IATF guidelines. We created the local IATF and having regular meetings on the update of the virus in the locality. We purchased supplies and materials to be fabricated as face masks and face shield to be distributed to the different barangays. We also procured hand washing facilities, non-touch alcohol dispensers, thermo scanners, sprayers for disinfection placed in the vicinity of our municipal halls and markets and other public places. We established checkpoints as border controls and strict control in the port of entry. Regular disinfection of every offices at 4 p.m. daily. Our office transactions are done on the windows. A mandatory swab testing was done to all barangay officials and to regular and job order employees for the safety of the co-workers and to the clients. The biggest task assigned to our office is the payout of the social amelioration program. Taking the risk on our health and safety, we are able to pay out 7,899 beneficiaries for the first tranche and 1,061 beneficiaries for the second tranche on the geographically isolated and disadvantaged area. We are the only LGU in Cebu who do the payout of the JEDA areas for the second tranche of SAP for the DSWD regional office. Hired us as a special disbursing officers for they believe in our capabilities and cooperation, for we are in the top 10 who finished the distribution of SAP on the first tranche. Cooperation and coordination with the SWD make our task so easy and successful. The elderly are not allowed to go out during the pandemic, for they are vulnerable to have the virus for their low immune system and mostly have underlying sickness because of their age. For our malasakit to them, we distributed the social pension house to house. Our hearts melt seeing them so happy receiving their pension without exposing them to risk. Adunay uban nga mihilak nga midawat ang uban usab sobra kamalipayon. Maura nay gitawag og serbisyong tuto. Our office, together with the DTI representative, conducted price monitoring and inventory of stocks to all big business establishments to prevent overpricing and hoarding. We also inspected the resorts if they follow the protocols and occupancy rates when they are allowed to operate back during the new normal. Sudden drop in the collection of taxes is expected due to the pandemic. Me, as the advisor of the local chief executive on fiscal matters, suggested to have a new economic enterprise to support the finances of the LGU. We have decided to buy a lot to be developed as municipal cemetery. We made a site inspection together with our municipal assessor and engineering department. And luckily, we have purchased it and started to develop the site. And this year, we can start pre-sealing it. Not all constituents are qualified to receive the social amelioration program. So we, the local finance committee, decided to give rise to all households in the municipality, either rich or poor, also in two tranches, out of the Bayanihan Fund downloaded to us by the national government. The DSWD, Accounting Office, and Treasury Department spearheaded the distribution.
In Matthew 25:40, it says, "Truly I tell you, whatever you do your least brothers and sisters, you do it for me." I am so happy that I have served others. I am Edna Carla Y. Arbuiz, the acting Municipal Treasurer of San Remigio, Cebu, nominated as Inspiring Municipal Treasurer amidst COVID-19 pandemic. Mag-heart na kayo dyan! We fight as one, we heal as one. Good day and God bless us
all. Ladies and gentlemen, our second nominee, Miss Edna Carla Arboyas. Good morning, Ma'am Edna.
Good morning,
Atty. And si Ma'am Edna Carla Arboyas is coming from San Remigio. Tell us about San Remigio, Ma'am. Where is it located, Ma'am?
San Remigio is located in the northern part of Cebu. It is a third-class municipality.
Naunahin ko yun, Ma'am. You are, yung distribution natin ng social amelioration program, you are one of the top 10 na natapos yung pag-distribute. Ang lahat ng mayor during the time, takot kasi habla daw, kakasuhan daw yung hindi makapag-distribute ng lahat ng social amelioration program. Congratulations for that one. How did you do that? Kasi ang gulo-gulo ng distribution nun parang mayroon pang mga concern na bakit hindi kami nasali. So, how do you do that? Ma'am, madali yung distribution ng SAPMA.
We have a cooperation with the DSWD. Nag-gawa kami ng 14 teams, partner-partner. Isa sa Treasury for the payout and sa DSWD for the validation of the yun sa SAP.
So yun kasi yung mga concern ng ibang treasury, sila yung inaaway, bakit hindi sila nasali yung mga beneficiary supposedly, or bakit nasali si ganito, ganyan. So, na-do away nyo yung ganyan kasi mayroon kayong two teams. Kayo, yung payout, at saka yung validation. So, nonetheless, have you encountered na inaaway pa rin kayo, ma'am? Kayong team mismo galing from treasury?
Naman, sir, pag nagtanong sa amin kung hindi sila nasali, anong namin sa DSWD? Sila ang mag-answer sa mga questions, mga queries.
Ang ganda sanang i-share niyan during the distribution kasi wala naman tayong kinalaman doon sa validation. Tayo ang payout lamang. Now, on the collection side, ma'am, I understand San Remigio is supposedly parang ang ganda na rin ng mga development dyan. Do you have ports coming from businesses din na pumapasok dyan? How was the pandemic affected the collection of the treasurer's office, ma'am?
Affected talaga. Ang number one na affected is the collection namin sa port. Kasi walang biyahe pa tungong sa Bantayan Island. So, yun ang affected. At saka sa real property at lahat-lahat. But not to with the business kasi continuous naman ang ano ng mga business establishments. Yung essential products, ano naman, kanang, yun ang, so, during the pandemic, yun ang ano, must, ano, kanang, syllable during the pandemic. So, hindi sila affected. Ang affected naman is the beach resorts.
Yun, oh, close kasi yung mga during the time. Oh.
Sure.
Ma'am, in your video presentation, pinakita nyo kasi during the time, yung kakapasok pa lang yung lockdown, nagka-shortage ng face mask. But San Remigio provided the people, you provided, yung LGU provided your people with face mask. Paano yun, ma'am?
Mister, bumili kami ng yung cloth na Alpha Gina. Binigay namin sa barangay, sila na ang mag-fabricate sa mask. Binigay namin sa kanila kasi hindi wala tayong mabili ng face mask yung ready na to wear, so we made renovations na nagbili kami ng cloth, so binigay namin sa kanila para sila ang maggumawa ng face mask.
So yun yung service at the heart talaga of it all na nakita ko kanina sa video presentation mo. Ikaw mismo yung nag-hand over doon sa mga pension benefits, financial assistance, tawagin muna nating financial assistance doon sa mga senior citizens. You go out talaga doon sa field, ma'am? Were you not afraid na ma-expose tayo sa COVID, ma'am?
Hindi naman, sir. Hindi. It doesn't come up on my mind na for my safety, but for the safety of the older, hindi kasi sila makalabas. Mas vulnerable sila kaysa akin. Mas ang immune system ko siguro mas mataas kaysa kanila.
Wow.
So, I sacrifice myself for them. Kasi, kasi, ma-think kasi, na ang parents ko ay senior citizens na rin.
Wow. No, no, I have to go directly to this one. Eh, what if mayroong makaka-COVID sa inyo dyan sa office? Sana wala. Or mayroong considered close contact. Matawa na si Ma'am Carlo. Ano yung mga standard protocol nyo dyan, ma'am?
Actually, attorney, last year sa 2020, wala pa kaming cases dito sa office namin. Mm-hmm. So, here comes the, when the, you know, yung nag-new normal na kasi open na lahat, wala nang mga restrictions, walang border controls, dito na dumating. I am one of the victim of COVID. Wow. I'm a survivor.
But fortunately, a survivor at that. Yun yung emphasize natin. Although si Ma'am Carla was exposed, katrabaho kasi ang division kasi ni Ma'am Carla was exposed, but nag-graduate na. So how was that, ma'am? What do you think? Did you get that, ma'am?
I don't think hindi ko ma-pen po when attorney. Actually, apat kami sa office na nag-positive.
Oh.
Ako ang una, then may tatlo na sumunod sa akin.
Oh.
So siguro, hindi natin mapinpoint kasi kung sa office tayo, meron tayong window transaction tayo. O merong mga clients na bago pa akong nag-pay out sa mga barangays for their incentive from the Malacanang, hindi ko nag-ano pa kami ngayon, nag-caravan of services every week. Pumunta kami sa barangay. So hindi ko mapinpoint kung saan ko nakuha at pag-uwi ko, pumunta ako sa mga malls, mag-shopping sa market. So hindi ko talaga kung saan ko nakuha ang virus.
Pero sabi nila kasi pag busy ka, yung immune system mo baka mag-down. So were you not considering na magpahinga rin minsan? Sa trabaho, baka doon kasi nag-down yung immune system natin doon sa kakabisi natin sa Treasurer's Office. Was it not a consideration for you to lay down muna, ma'am? O yung service pa rin yung nananaig? Sabi mo nga, you have an elderly parent rin, senior citizen pa rin. Oh, yes, ma'am.
Naka-vacation ako for 14 days in the isolation. Okay na yun. Normal.
Congratulations. A testament, a living testament niya, matitigas itong mga treasurers natin. Hindi basta-bastang natatablan. At saka nag-graduate. Yan. Good to know, ma'am. Now, proceed na tayo doon. Good to know. In God's grace, talagang we were worried talaga hearing the news coming from you na ganyan yung situation. So, good to know na ang ma-highlight natin ngayon, you are one of the survivor. Hindi talaga. Yes. So, would you say na napakahirap na sakit itong COVID, ma'am?
Hindi naman. Hindi naman, attorney. It's just parang normal na flu.
So you were asymptomatic or symptomatic?
I am symptomatic. Yun lang. Ang nakaiba, nawala ang smell ko at saka taste. Yun lang.
At saka ang hirap, yung i-isolate ka sa family mo.
That's it.
For 14 days? So ano yung ginagawa mo dun, ma'am? So how does that feel? How's the boredom striking you?
What I did is pinadala ko mga cashbook ko dun.
Trabaho pa rin, ha? Ikaw ha, trabaho ka pa rin. Sige, proceed, ma'am. Proceed. Sige.
I have my prayer time. Yeah, mag-watch na lang ng Netflix kung na-board.
What is the isolation facility, ma'am? Hospital or yung sa isolation facility ng LGU?
Sa LGU. Sa LGU lang at yun eh.
So doon ka nag... ibig sabihin, maganda yung isolation facility nyo dyan. Kasi pinili mo dyan eh.
Yes. Okay naman, attorney. Dito na lang ako. Sino-choose ko na dito sa San Romeo ako mag-isolate. Although, taga-Bugo ako.
Uh-huh.
Kasi para it's easy for them na makasign din ako sa check. Pupunta ka na nila, i-disinfect nila ang lahat ng mga
So for the benefit of viewing public, paano yung transaction sa isolation center, ma'am? Yung mga cashbook, iniiwan sa labas o ano? Paano yun kinukuha, ma'am?
Inilagay nila sa labas yung cashbook.
Okay.
Nakalabas ang cashbook, paglabas ko din sa isolation at ilagyan ng Lysol. Yun ang sa check-in naman, kung magpa-sign ko ng check, nakabalot ro, yun ang check. Pag-sign ko, gloves.
Okay.
Then, pag-abot, pag ilalagay ko na naman sa labas.
Talagang ito, oh. How was your daily needs, ma'am? Yung food, yung mga, ano-ano mo, yung mga needs mo dyan, ano yan?
Supervised by the LGU, ang daily needs namin, sir, sa isolation. That's why malaki ang ano namin gasto sa isolation facility namin. Kasi nag-follow ang pagkain, pina-follow ang diet para madali makarecover ang patient.
Oh, balik na naman tayo sa trabaho. Nga, yun nga, procurement of COVID-related supplies. How was it sa San Remigio? Ano yung mga naibenta nyo? Aside from yung supplies of food na regimen, yung napaka-nutritious, yung isolation center niyo, ma'am, how was that funded? Ano ito? Coming from Bayanihan Grant o LGU mismo na funding, ma'am?
LGU na ang nag-fund.
What is this isolation facility, ma'am? Parang gym o parang ano siya? Parang resort?
Meron kaming housing unit, National Housing Authority, na hindi pa na-award sa mga recipient. Okay. Yun ginamit
ng LGU. Oh.
So, ang facility, ang patient ay naka-confine sa isang house, isang unit. So, malaki ang space, well ventilated. So, natagang hindi nag-ano ang patient.
And this isolation facility would not have been possible if walang proper guidance ng ating municipal treasurer na member pa rin ng local finance committee. Now, punta na tayo doon sa strictness in your health protocol doon sa office, ma'am. That has been dumaan na yung pagka-COVID victim natin at saka survivor. Now, looking forward, how would you enforce itong health protocols natin dyan sa office at saka sa clientele? At the rate of 1 being the lenient at 5 being the strictest, how would you rate now your observing of the minimum health protocols, ma'am Edna?
Carla? Oh, before kami nagka-COVID, mga 4 siguro. Pero ngayon, na victim na kami, mga 5 na. Mga 5 na siguro.
Okay. So ito tanong ko, pag nakita mo yung staff mo na hindi naka-face mask, tapos nag-uusap sa katabi niyang staff, ano yung ginagawa niyo dyan, ma'am?
Ako na ang mag-remind nila, always wear your face mask.
Oh, so the moral of it is, even if hindi ka matatablan ng COVID, magiging survivor ka, napakahirap magiging isolated sa friends and family mo, ma'am.
And discrimination din, attorney.
Yes, yan. Yung parang stigma, nga.
Matakot sila sa, parang matakot siya sa inyo, hindi sila lumapit. So, okay. What I did is, hindi na lang ako, minsan na ako lumabas sa office ko, nandito na lang ako sa...
Information lang sa mga viewers. Is it a requirement na bago ka mag-graduate, iswab uli o wala na yan?
Kuan lang. Sa dito sa amin, rapid test lang. I-check yung antibodies mo, yata, yung IgG. Kung okay na siya. Makita naman doon.
Nag-pass si Ma'am Carla. Pasado ka doon.
Yes. Recovered na kayo from previous ka ng parang may virus. Ganon siguro.
Ito yung pinakamalaking achievement mo, Ma'am Carla. Ito, being a COVID graduate and survivor. Now, ituloy ko lang yung pagtanong. What practices have you introduced in your offices and even in the entire LGU, ma'am, to prevent or mitigate COVID transmission?
Pag sa entrance, merong scanner na mag-determine ng temperature. Meron kaming ilinagay na mga hand washing facilities doon outside sa
sanitation.
Sa lobby ng municipal hall, meron kaming mga non-touch alcohol dispensers. Yun. Ang transaction namin sa office na nasa window.
Ayan, transaction, ma'am. Talking about transaction, was the transaction in the treasurer's office? Kasi there was a time suspended yung field activities. How affected were you, ma'am, during the lockdown, yung operations ng ating treasurer's office?
During the lockdown, hindi kami nag-work from home. Kasi hindi nag-issue ng memo ang mayor na mag-work from home kami. Maaga lang kaming umuwi every day at 4 p.m. kasi i-disinfect ang mga office namin. We reported to office every day. Every day. Kasi hindi namin magawa na mag-work from home kasi ang mayor namin nandito every day. No choice.
The Treasurer's Office is one of the most exposed offices doon sa EDSA kasi nga ang daming taong nating nakasasalamuha dyan, taxpayers man or yung mga concern. Now, have you introduced alternative ways in transacting with your clients, ma'am?
Wala. Yun lang ang window transaction ng attorney. Pero yung at the onset of the pandemic, limited lang naman ang nagbabayad ng mga taxes.
Wala masyado.
They are not allowed to go out of their house.
So nandal, ma'am, hindi naman sila nagkumpul-kumpul doon sa labas. Walang crowding sa ating treasurer's office.
Ano namin, sa labas, yung sa window, may window transaction, may markings kami sa floor for the social distancing.
Do you have priority numbers pa rin, queuing, para hindi naman sila mag-tulakan doon?
Wala naman, pero hindi naman. Siguro yun lang sa pag-renewal sa business permit. Maraming tao. Pero per barangay. Yung everyday that barangay para hindi crowded. Na malaki naman ang ano namin, one-stop shop. Yung sa social hall namin ginawa.
Now, I have to congratulate my mom again for being a COVID survivor. And again, yung lesson learned ko doon sa distribution ng SAP nyo, dapat sana mayroong teams, isang team sa payout at saka doon sa validation para hindi naaawa yung mga treasurers. Ma'am Edna Carla Arboyes, at this juncture, I will implore you to invite our viewers to heart react your photo picture doon sa ating FB page live at saka to vote you pa rin naman sa ating most inspiring at outstanding treasurer amid the pandemic. Go ahead, Ma'am Carla.
I am worth to have your heart. So just remember, Edna Carla Y. Arboyes, the COVID survivor.
Heart na. Yun yung sabi mo, mami. Heart na kayo. Ayan. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. Our second nominee coming from the Treasury Service Cebu Province still, Ms. Edna Carla Arboyes, COVID survivor. Ardi! Nakilala na natin si Ms. Edna Carla, di ba? Isa ito sa ating interview during doon sa virtual interview as application doon sa Municipal Treasurer. What would you say, Ardi? Palaban siya doon sa ating interview. Dito, palaban pa rin pala sa COVID, Ardi?
That's right. So, actually, towards June na yung ano niya, yung second level requirement for the processing of her appointment for full-pledged Municipal Treasurer of San Remigio. So we are waiting for your compliance para ma-forward na natin sa central office yung appointment.
Yes, thank you, RD.
Hey, RD, COVID survivor pala to, RD. Anong masabi mo, RD? Palaban to, matitigas to. Thank you, RD. I'll get back to you later on. Thank you, Ms. Edna Carla Arboyes. That was our second nominee for the most inspiring treasurer amidst COVID. Yan. Dalawang nominees na ang nakilala na for this episode. Tuloy tayo mamaya sa ating third nominee. In the meantime, pass shout out, sigaw palabas muna sa ating mga viewers. Go ahead, Miss Jona Nabilia, pasok na.
Happy Lorenzo Charles Jucar. Good morning po. We are watching here in Office of the Provincial Assessors Isabella. Isabella, that's read June 2. At saka Moises Baruga from LGU Kabarugis. Saan yung Kabarugis? And shout out sa beautiful wife ng ating RD, kay Marie Ave. Nanonood siya. Thank you for watching, ma'am. Shout out po, sabi ni Christina Patalinghog ng Tanhay City Assessor, isigaw mo naman ako palabas, sabi niya. Perna Testimonio. Shout out kay Jesusa Diposa, the City Treasurer of Gihulngan, kay Juliet Valdez ng LGU Can Aved Eastern Samar Assessor's Office, kay Virgilia Rufo Opone ng Assessor's Office ng Sibunga, kay Marilo Arante ng Aluginsan, Edsel Laguda ng San Fernando, Cebu Shirley Carbonell ng Municipal Assessor's Office ng San Luis Aurora. So Aurora Province, that's Region 2, sabi ni Perasol Humuat Trinidad, well said, Lo. Tinuto kanya to kay Mama Lo Herrera, well said, Lo. Proud ACMA member and secretary here, sabi niya. Mm. Sabi naman ni Judith Martinez, good morning everyone. I cheer for our representative Marilo Herrera of Cebu Province. Mm. Sabi naman ni Hazel Faith Pedrosa, proud San Remihanon here. So, sa'yo yun, Ma'am Edna Carla. And go, Madam Marilo Herrera, sabi ni Elsa Kabatbat. And sabi ni Ma'am Eva De Leon, go ahead, my BFF. Congratulations. Para ho yun kay Ma'am Carla Arbo.
Ayan. Thank you, Miss Juna Novelia. Salamat, Nay. Ayan. Daming mga fans ng ating nominees ngayon, ha? So, iti-take opportunity ko rin yung pag-shoutout. Advance happy birthday sa butihing nanay ko tomorrow, bukas, March 23, birthday niya. I forgot how old is she na. So, advance happy birthday, mami. Ayan. So, let's now go ahead sa ating third nominee. Yes, Ardy, go ahead, Ardy.
Sa birthday celebrant tomorrow. Beka naman. Pwede naman ka.
Baka naman. Ewan ko. Baka mayanda ba kaya yung mother ko. She's coming from the prosecutor's office. Nag-retire na. So, baka naman, ma'am. Okay. Thank you, Adi. Ayan. Punta na tayo sa ating third nominee. Wait mo na. Okay. Okay, medyo na-shock ako. Kasi dito sa... Okay. In the meantime na nag-greet ako sa mother ko sa birthday niya. Yung kasamahan nanay, unfortunately, yung nanay ng kasamahan namin, si Sir Edwin C. Villanueva, passed away just this day daw, yung araw na to. Condolence, Sir Edwin Villanueva. Our prayers are for you and your family. Malampasan din natin ito. Again, condolence, Sir Edwin C. Villanueva. Okay, pardon us for that, but medyo kailangan na natin papasadahan din yon. Ladies and gentlemen, balik na nga tayo. Ayan, naka-standby na si ma'am. Si ma'am, third nominee natin ngayon, isa sa pinuntahan ni RD. Galing sa LGU pa rin na basta. I-introduce siya mamaya sa ating video presentation. So, isa ito sa mga pinaglaban ni Ardin na gawing assessor talaga. So, isang witness ito, how palaban si Ardin when it comes to treasury and assessment concern. Ladies and gentlemen, standby production team for our third nominee this time representing assessment group coming from Cebu Province. Go ahead, production team. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, continuing to serve the municipal, the constituents of the municipality of LGU San Remo, no matter what. The municipal assessor herself, Miss Vilma Saldua. Good morning, ma'am. Bati naman dyan. Ayan, nakamute yata, ma'am. Or walang headset si ma'am. Kanina lang we established communication with Ma'am Vilma. So what happened? We still can't hear you, Ma'am Vil. Yan, yan. We can hear you na. Go ahead. Greet them. Greet our viewers muna, ma'am.
Greetings from LGU San Remo. This is Vilma Saldua at your service.
Ayan. Almost pala yung ating municipality of San Remo. Kanina, nakausap natin yung treasurer. This time, the assessor na naman. Ayan. Vilma yung kakausapin natin. Ma'am, I am very appreciative yung sinasabi mo doon sa presentation. I am very grateful of having this job notwithstanding the pandemic. Can you elaborate further on that, ma'am?
Yes, sorry. Kasi even pandemic, ang service natin hindi mawawala. Nandun pa rin parang normal ang trabaho, nadadagdagan pa.
So that is what motivated you to serve better during this pandemic, yung sinasabi mong I am just very grateful that no matter what ay mayroon pa ring trabahong I am having during this pandemic, ma'am.
Yeah, attorney, iba kasi yung feeling kung nakakatulong ka sa iba, lalo na those times sa pandemic, ang daming dapat tulungan.
And you feel more rich daw, sabi nila, Miss, mukhang mayaman tayo. Pag tumutulong kayo sa iba, we feel more parang we have a lot pag tumutulong tayo sa iba. So, ano yung activities na pinapakita natin kanina, ma'am, yung nag-distribute kayo ng food packs?
Actually, ito kasi part ako ng business association. Nag-initiate kami ng magbigay ng mga food packs kay pinili kami ng isang barangay. And same with my high school batch, nag-raise kami ng funds to help also dun sa mga classmates namin, high school classmates na nangailangan. So parang in-identify namin kung sino yung nangailangan. So,
coming from you first hand, ma'am, medyo mahirap ba talaga during lockdown yung pangailangan? Ultimo yung 10 kilos of socks, talagang kailangan talaga ng ating mga kababayan?
Kaming nawawala ng trabaho. Good for us na nasa government service dahil okay naman tayo. Yung mga nasa maliit na companies, so knowing na ang daming companies na nag-down, so yung mga taga-amin na trabaho, ang daming nagsipag-OEM.
So, kumusta naman yung exposure niyo, ma'am? Kasi during that activity, ang daming tao siguro magkukumpul-kumpul. Were you not afraid na baka masyadong exposed kayo doon sa COVID?
Talagang exposed, attorney. So kailangan na natin i-boost ang health natin. So
right, immune system.
Tapos pag-uwi, hindi papasok ng bahay pag hindi nakaligo. Maliligo kami.
Yan, yung damit talaga laba agad. Yan, parang ako rin nung una. So in the event, ma'am. Yeah, sorry. In the event, ma'am, itatanong ko rin, in the event naging considered close contact, I understand si Ma'am Carla Arbues kanina nagka-COVID survivor pala yon. So in the event na mayroong close contact kayo diyan, ma'am, ano yung protocol na ginagawa niyo diyan sa office, ma'am?
Actually, attorney, ako ang close contact ni Ma'am Carla. Ay, yes, free kami talagang palaging magkasama. So si Ma'am Carla, nung nalaman ko na positive, ako nag-isolate ako sa bahay.
So isolated. Okay.
Ako pinapos ko talaga yung 2 weeks. Ngayon lang ako bumalik ng office.
Well, congrats. But during that isolation, ma'am, were you feeling something or asymptomatic ka ba?
Asymptomatic naman ako. Ang problema kasi sa akin, allergy ako sa mga tabo,
so medyo takot, ano ba to, symptoms na ba to? Kasi baka ma-misread natin na symptoms ito COVID, pero allergy lang yun, ma'am. Good naman.
Alam ko yung health, ano problem ko talaga. Ako yet mabango. Sobrang bango, affected na ako niyan. So, nag-isolate ako sa bahay lang namin with the care of my husband.
So, paano yan, ma'am? Yung family mo hindi makalapit sa'yo o ibang room ka?
Di sa lumapit na sa taas na yung mga anak ko. Ako nasa room sa labas. So, ako yung gumamit ng labas sa baba, sa first floor.
So mahirap pa rin notwithstanding.
Mahirap pa rin dahil hindi ka pwedeng lumabas eh. Nasa kwarto ka lang. So gusto kong magpainit ng araw, ayun, antayin ko pa yung hapon, bubuksan ko yung bintana.
Sinasabi ni Ma'am Carla Edna Carla Arboyes kanina, yung stigma daw. So how was that, ma'am? Ano yung parang discrimination daw na close contact kayo.
Yes. Sa mga group chats ko na nakakapunan ng positive kay pumunta ng bahay. Mm-hmm. Ang dito lang sa office.
Survive nga eh. Gusto dyan. Go ahead, ma'am. Go ahead, ma'am Belma.
Parang libangan eh. Ma'am Carla naka-isolate, tapos kami naka-isolate din. So meron kaming group chat, nama namin yung mga staff sa treasurer's office. Ayun, yun yung isang libangan.
Thank you. In God's blessing, survivor pa rin si Ma'am Delma Saldoa. Ayan. Now, punta na tayo dun, ma'am. Looking forward, kasi mahirap talaga yung, if not for the symptoms, kasi asymptomatic naman, kasi allergy lang, yung isolation talaga yung pinakahirap. So, looking forward, how would you enforce yung mga minimum health protocol dyan sa office mo dyan, ma'am?
Actually, gaya na sinabi ni Ma'am Carla, meron kaming mga washing area bago pagpasok. Temperature. Aside from that, sa office namin, bago ka pumasok, may dispenser din ng alcohol. Then we have air humidifier inside our office.
Ayan. Stricto ka ba doon sa mga observance of health protocol, ma'am? In a rate of 1 to 5, 1 being the lenient and 5 the strictest. Paano tayo mag-rate, ma'am, sa implementation of protocol?
I think 4.
Bakit naman?
Sa amin kasi, ang office namin, unlike sa treasury, naka-window sila, meron window. Sa amin, plan pa lang, hindi pa nagagawa. So, outside our office, is nilagyan namin yung table doon. Nandun yung mga forms kung anong transaction. Isang staff na nandun. Tapos ibigay na ipasok na lang niya. Ibigay dito sa
door. Punta ako dyan sa office nyo somewhere back, ma'am. Nasa baba pa rin ba yung office nyo, ma'am?
Yes, same pa rin.
So, medyo yung hallway yun. Paano yun? Hindi ba yun nagkukumpulan yung mga tao doon?
Hindi. Kasi ang ginawa namin during lockdown, close namin. One entrance na lang. Di ba may entrance sa amin yung
So, hindi na siya ginawang hallway. Hindi na siya hallway.
So, isang daanan na lang talaga.
Tapos,
sa labas namin, ano na yung mga chairs na naka-arrange na sa physical distancing.
Alam natin minsan yung mga clientele natin nagmamadali, so hindi na na-observe yung mga physical distancing. Paano natin sila rini-remind, ma'am?
Nangyari lang yan, attorney, nung bayaran ng mga taxes. So, ang daming tao, sabay-sabay eh. So, kailangan kasi para kasi nanalate which topic sa revision or so, saka notice of assessment. So, ginawa na namin trans na bago sila makapagbayad ng tax, dadaan mo na sa assessor's office, kukuha sila ng notice of assessment. Tax declaration. So, talagang matatagalan. So, ang ginawa namin, kukunin na lang namin yung resibo nila, tapos doon sila sa labas, tatawagin namin kung tapos na. At para mabawasan, yung iba sabi ko, kung yung mga malapit lang, nag-a-announce kami, malapit lang, pwede nyo balikan bukas. And sometimes, gagawin na namin joke, sige, pasyal muna kayo doon sa lapyahan. Doon sa Korean shopping muna kayo. Tapos yung ano nila, mabawasan yung pang ano namin.
Yeah, inaabot yun yung long queuing diyan at saka pagkukumpulan. Now, yeah, sa office niyo, ma'am, hindi natin maiwasan yung kumakain sabay-sabay o may mayroon bang sinasaway yung eating together, ma'am?
Sa office kasi namin na Rony, hindi na makakain ng sabay-sabay talaga dahil sa dami ng tao. Oh. So, isa-isahan na lang, kanya-kanya na lang sila ba?
Can you tell me something about, alam ko nag-general revision ka. Ano yung ginagawa during general revision, ma'am? Kasi alam ko, you finished your books November of 2020. So ano ba yung ginagawa ng general revision, ma'am?
General revision, grabe yung challenge sa training. Kasi ilan lang kami? 6 lang kami sa office. Tapos meron akong OGT. Ano nangyari? During lockdown, pinatigil yung mga pumasok sa school. So, ang ginawa ko, sabi ko, okay lang ba kayo, patuloy lang kayo, tapos parang ako na lang magbibigay sa inyo.
Wow! Wow!
Before the general revision, kasi meron kaming weekly meeting. Tapos,
ilan sila, ma'am? Ilan sila? Ilan itong mga estudyante mo?
Dalawa. Okay, dalawa sila. Tapos sila yung parang na-train dun sa new system namin kasi nagbago kami ng...
So, mahirap bitawan.
Oo. So, ang maganda lang kasi inopen ko kay Mayor. So, Mayor, ang we have a short time kasi sa general revision na...
Si Gob, gustong-gusto na i-implement yun Sabi ni Gob Garcia.
Tapos, so, inopen ko kay Mayor, sabi ko, Mayor, pwede pa mag-overtime na lang kami. So, maganda. Kasi,
support. So, overtime during the pandemic, ma'am. So, how was that? Shifting ba? Para katulad kay Ma'am Maluera?
Wala kami shifting lang kasi...
How many are you in there, ma'am? Yung staff, ma'am, sa staff mo?
During the general revision talaga, ang employed is 5. Tapos, may dalawa akong...
Okay.
Okay na yung overtime.
Wow, grabe ka na.
Dalawa. Bakit pa nag-hire ako ng 4?
For emphasis ha, ulit ko, baka hindi naninig ng viewers. Yung overtime pay down ni Ma'am Vilma, yun yung binabayan niya doon sa mga estudyante niyang nag-OGT sa kanya. Para lang matapos yung pandemic. Now, itatanong ko rin ito, Ma'am. How was the general revision affected by the lockdown? Yung mga prohibition of going out in the field during anong buwan yun? So, how was that the field activity affected, Ma'am?
Affected talaga kasi hindi kami pwedeng lumabas. Tsaka yung puso namin na tour, tapusin talaga yung revision kasi kaya kinukulit na kami o kailangan na, alam mo na
kayo. Ma'am, bigyan pa kita ng pagkakataon. I-shout out mo yung mga staff mo na tumutulong na matapos yung revision mo,
ma'am. Okay. My God, nag-presented so kahit na may health niya, may problema, pero...
Si Sir Edison, okay.
Okay. To Wilma, to Bulletin, to Justin. And as of now, ang OGT ko na natira si Rosel na inabsorb na rin.
Na-absorb na yung mga OGT mo? Sa assessor's office din? Ginagawa ko ito kasi sinasabi ni Ma'am Vilma, out from her overtime pay, binabayaran niya yung OGT niya para lang matapos yung general revision. Panghuling tanong, have you introduced, kasi nahihirapan tayo during this pandemic and in fact, yung mga face-to-face transaction minsan dinidiscourage. So, have you introduced yung mga alternative way of transacting to your clients, ma'am?
Naglagay kami ng forms dun sa labas kung ano yung transaction nila, check lang nila, tapos i-forward to sa loob namin kasi wala kaming window pa So yun yung ginagawa
na. Sabi mo, you plan to have barrier yung window na parang yung transaction hindi na talaga close contact, di ba, ma'am? Okay, go ahead, ma'am. Go ahead. So yung forms nilalagay sa labas. Tapos
yung sa loob ng office namin, in-adjust namin, meron pa rin upuan kasi minsan hindi mo mapigilan, papasok talaga. So, kailangan talagang kausapin sila. So, ang ginawa namin, in-adjust namin na kahit uupo sila sa chair, medyo may distance pa rin.
I have been to your office, ma'am. Nakita ko doon, you have a lot of storage area, yung mga books mo dyan. So, paano yan? Nag-revision ngayon, lalong dumami yung mga storage natin dyan. Oh.
Yes, attorney. Actually, kasya pa naman. Pero, galing naman na bumili sa mayroon parang separate area, lalo
na
sa mga
shout out na rin kay Mayor Martinez sa pagtulong sa ating assessors. At this juncture, bigyan kita ng pagkakataon na para ma-invite yung mga Facebook page viewers natin to heart react, to vote for you sa photo mo as the most inspiring and outstanding assessor amidst the pandemic. Go ahead, Ma'am Vilma.
Okay, I would like to take this opportunity. Actually, attorney, na-touch ako during the isolation time ko ba. Yung pagbukas ko ng Facebook, nakita ko ang dami palang sumuporta. Naging emotional ako noon. I would like to take this opportunity to my friends, my family, my colleagues, na yung ang gaganda, my churchmate, na yung family ko, na grabe ang support nila. And everyone, hindi pa naka-vote, pa-heart naman to.
Pa-heart naman po. Heart na. Yan yung sabi ko na. Ladies and gentlemen, yes, go ahead, Ma'am Bel.
I would like to take this opportunity also to thank RD. Alam nyo, RD, grabe. Mangiyak-iyak ako nag-share.
Tatanungin ko yan mamaya, ma'am. Ibabanter ko yan. Ano yung nangyari? Bakit nagpapasalamat si Ma'am Vilma kay RD, Dr. Lero? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that was our third nominee, the municipal as Remigio Cebu, Vilma Saldoa. Pahard na. RD, I need to talk to you, RD. Sobrang mangingiyak-ngiyak daw si Ma'am Vilma. Bakit kaya, RD? We lost contact with your... Okay, we can hear you na, RD. Okay. Kasi itong si RD napunta ng San Remigio eh nakitang kay tagal na pala ni Ms. Vilma, hindi pa pledge appointed assessor. So ano yung nangyari, RD?
It was a blessing in disguise siguro. Minsan pala, yung mga bagay-bagay na hindi natin nakikita yung problem. So yung...
Pag hindi napuntahan.
The problem nila is internal. Okay? So... I just medyo worried kami nga nung bakit hindi pa na-appoint si Ma'am Vilma. In fact, the mayor itself is very willing. Is very willing to appoint her as full-fledged municipal assessor. Okay? So medyo may issue doon sa HR.
Sa internal. Ha? So paano yan, Andy? Isa pala itong COVID isolation. Isolated lang kasi hindi naman na talagang na-positive. Matitigas din pala itong mga assessor, Andy. Congratulations to Ma'am Vilma. Yeah.
Yes, congratulations Ma'am Vilma for graduating without COVID.
Ayan.
Congratulations, yeah. Ma'am.
Okay. Anaika.
So effective siya, naging municipal assessor ako January.
Oh, magiging municipal assessor na si Ma'am. Oh, RD. So Ma'am Vilma Saldo, ang tagal na nitong nasa municipal assessor's office noon pa lang. Ito na yung right hand at saka pinaka trusted ni Ma'am doon nag-retire. Okay. Congrats, Ma'am Vilma. Okay. Now, at this juncture, before we proceed with our last, yung pinaka-exciting nating nominee coming from the city group, Treasury Service pa rin. Before that, punta muna tayo doon sa ating comment section natin si Ms. June Ann Abilia. Pasok na, ay.
Yes. Sabi ni Ma'am Belen Monial Ormega, congrats, Ma'am Edna Carla Y. Arboyes. Sabi naman ni Ma'am Annette Vero, really proud of our two nominees from Cebu Province for the most inspiring assessors amidst COVID-19. The way you handle challenges in our job in spite of our situation will inspire others as well. Good job, sabi ni Ma'am.
Our provincial assessor yan.
Okay. Sabi naman ni Sir Ramel Archaga, good morning BLGF7 and all your viewers today. everybody is watching. Wow! Isang liig na? Liig! Liig talaga ng buhol! Sabi naman ni Juliet Aying, Lapu-Lapu City Treasurer's Office, i-shout out mo naman kami ni Nen Raso Guarin at ni Lina Ramirez Ryuan ng PTO Masbate City. Shout out from Municipal Assessor of Bataraza, Palawan. Kudos to my BFF, Municipal Assessor of Consolacion Cebu, Marilu Herrera. Please give her a
coming
heart.
Coming from Palawan, Mamalu. Coming from Palawan, BFF mo daw. Yes, na ipasok
na. Congrats to our Municipal Treasurer of San Remigio, Madam Edna Carla Y. Arboyes. Isang heart para sa'yo. Sabi naman ni Ma'am Aileen, go, 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 Carla. And Imelda Rivera, sabi niya, congrats, Ma'am Edna of LGU San Remigio. So far, Tours!
Ay, ganay! Ayan, exciting itong next nominee natin kasi galing siya sa city na medyo mahirap din yung sitwasyon during that time sa COVID. Itong city pa naman ito, may naandun yung parang entrance ng mga foreigner at saka returning OFW. I'm talking about Lapu-Lapu City. Production, pasok ko na video introduction. Go ahead!
Mandirig mang Pilipino, takila ang lahi ko, layaning Pilipino sa makabagong panahon.
In the middle of this COVID-19 pandemic, the Office of the City Treasurer was able to carry out its duties and tasks despite the risk of exposure to the virus. We were able to distribute the social amelioration program to the beneficiaries, disburse the honorarium and the senior citizen PWD cash gift to their respective barangays. In preparation of the periodic renewal of business permit for this year, 2021, we consider the taxpayers' burden in paying their obligation to the city. We try our best to have our online assessment for the renewal of business permit, which is now currently used. Online payment is still in the process of finalization and hopefully will run before the deadline of the second quarter business tax. We were worried that our community tax certificates are not enough during this period, and there is a need for us to purchase it before the year started. Due to travel restriction, the procedure in purchasing these accountable forms was difficult to purchase since it was our first time to process it online. And one of the requirements was the submission of my specimen signature. It took efforts to look for the specimen card and figure out on how to acquire the said form from the National Printing Office, which is also based in Manila. Fortunately, we were able to purchase the community tax certificate in due time. Some local treasurer also experienced the difficulty in purchasing the cedula, and I openly share them my experience and how I made it. Although this pandemic greatly affects our tourism industry, the bread and butter of our economy, we generated local source revenue lesser than our previous year's collection. However, at the end of the year 2020, the city realized an unappropriated surplus that will be used to fund this year's plan and program. I hope this pandemic will end, and looking forward to the new normal. Stay safe, everyone, and God bless.
Ladies and gentlemen, our fourth nominee for the most inspiring treasurer amidst the pandemic, this city treasurer of Lapu-Lapu City, a resort city, Miss Felicitas Baguio. Good morning, Ma'am Fel.
Good morning, Amanda. Good morning, Ardi, and to all staff in VLGF. Everyone, now, good morning. Lapu-lapu.
Yes, ma'am. Lapu-Lapu City is a resort city. Ang daming resort niyan. Eh, one of the most affected na activity during lockdown is yung mga tourism activity. So, how was that affected sa collections at saka revenue generation effort ng Lapu-Lapu, ma'am? Na-affected ba tayo doon?
Yes, attorney, really affected. Actually, ang atong collection karon is lower than the 19 sa last year's nga collection. Pero actually, we always remind them to pay. We send billings. Some are trying hard to pay it. So that's why our collection has still realize
a
surplus.
Ah, wow. Huh? Notwithstanding the pandemic. Huh? And
even though we did not reach the target.
Oh. So surplus mayroon pa rin medyo nag-exceed pa rin yung mga collection natin vis-a-vis the needs the four forces. Now, I understand medyo na unti-unting nag-o-open na yung mga resorts natin diyan ka with the strict requirement of the province na yung mga training and so on and so forth. So, paano yung mga renewal of business permit, ma'am? Pumupunta pa rin sila sa office? Eh, ang dami niyan. I heard kanina, sabi mo, mayroon kayong online assessment of business permit. Can you talk about that, ma'am?
Yes, attorney. Actually, ang city of Lapu-Lapu, we have already an existing EGAPS.
EGAPS,
meaning,
okay.
Electronic Government Application System.
Okay.
And nakalink na siya sa assessors, sa treasurer, sa mayor's office, sa itong accounting, sa budget. In the renewal of the business...
Yeah, I'm a business owner. Mayroon akong business. How would I renew my business permit through online, ma'am?
Yes. Mo-open na lang sila dito sa atuang website. Then, ilahang i-encode ang ilahang gross sales. Mm-hmm. Then, they will wait for 24 hours for us to review and confirm and approve for them to assess. Then, makareceive sila email na pwede na nilang i-assess ang ilahang application. So, the taxpayer will be the one to print the assessment.
Assessment. So, hindi na kailangang magkukumpul-kumpul at pupunta down sa City Treasurer's Office. Kasi, I understand, nasa babang area yung Treasurer's Office ng Lapu-Lapu, di ba, ma'am?
Actually, attorney, during the renewal period, dito mi sa Hoops Dome.
Doon sa gym mismo. Okay, okay.
Sa atong mayor na convenient atong mga taxpayer ang process sa ilang business permit. So, dako ang lugar sa Hoops Dome.
Well ventilated. Now, I am reminded sa Hoops Dome yun, ma'am. Kasi during the time, during the lockdown, bawal yung mga tricycle. And Lapu-Lapu City is one of the cities na distributed mga trans program doon sa tricycle operators. How was that, ma'am? Have you been part of that? Ano yung pinamimigay natin sa tricycle operators at saka drivers?
Actually, wala kayo kung nakuha na sa na side attorney. Sa mayor's side naman na siya.
Okay.
So more on derira ko sa collection side during anak nga. Yeah, pero naang ito yung incentives, gipangatag si mayor katong na ay magdalag mga pamphlets kanang pagpahibaw parti sa unsa ka kuyaw ang COVID.
Ilang di pa
awareness sa
bicycle driver. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, with this kanang social amelioration program, you were tasked also together with the DSWD to distribute SAP. So, was that difficult, ma'am? Katong lalis-lalison ta nganong wa maapil ilang pangan?
Yes, attorney. Sige, jud mi ato maawayan, pero at least amo lang itong pasapton nga kaning SAP actually dili ni sa local siguro ming utilize para ma-distribute sa ila. Kung naay something wrong nga wala sila na appeal sa payroll amo ipaadto sa DS, so ang DS na mo explain nila.
Pero nahurot gyud og distribute nang dalis, ma'am.
Actually, doon na pa siya gamay nga wala mong ma-distribute attorney, pero ang itong kuan sa accounting nga gamiton lang gid itiwas lang gid bitaw ko I don't know nanam to deadline gid
lagi but were you not afraid that you were
na disperse
were you not afraid that you were that exposed sa ato sa COVID considering na atas gawas niya daghang tao bang inig distribute sa SAP so how did you feel during that distribution of SAP ma'am?
Yes, attorney. Ako na yung giingnan ako mga staff na you have to think na every person nga inyong maatubang, matapad, na ay COVID.
Oh, oh,
para
oh.
Managang yun mo for me.
Yeah.
Mga na ako ang giyod niya. Kanang protect yourself.
Now, in terms of businesses, ma'am, I know Ma'am Philly Baguio is one of the very active good nga mo kandak mga tax mapping mo antog yung mga businesses kay labi na nga resort gining Lapu-Lapu City. How is that affected nga suspended ma mga field activities ma'am? How are those activities done instead of going out ma'am?
So mo na siya attorney, wala na lang gyud may mag tax mapping aning mga atong niaging tuig pero ang amo ang billing continue gid na akong gipahatod taxpayer dili sila magsige makaari mangutana ang uban ibayad na lang nila through sa amo ang direkta nila i-deposit sa amo depository account.
Okay, one of the notable achievements that you have kuan nga that we have to share yung purchase of the cedula kasi mahirap ngayon ang travel. How was that done ma'am? How were you able to purchase notwithstanding the restrictions for travel ma'am?
Yes attorney, with the help of BLGF office, nag-inquire ko unsaon, then BLGF central office, hangtod, ila kong ipahibaw, itagaan ko nilang kopya atong specimen card, dayon, okay. Nangutana na po ko dito sa among supplier, atong mag-aaka itong sa NPO, nga mag-purchase ato. So at least, pamalihugan na mo sila, nga mo ato sa NPO office, nga ila ipada sa amo.
There was an actual travel, needed actual travel to purchase that, ma'am.
No, gikuan na, naitaw dito nga among gipamalihugan. Dayon ni, i-coordinate na lang sa diri sa among gi-mail na lang po to ang form kid attorney.
Now, would you say nga this lockdown, this pandemic, these restrictions have greatly affected the performance of the treasurer's office, ma'am? Nagkalisod ba trabaho sa treasurer, ma'am?
Yes, attorney. In fact, pag budget preparation na mo, nagsus na agi something, murag, kanang ang sa side sa kanang sa mayors kanang padak-an gid ang budget oh, sa side sa treasury pakunhuran ko ang budget
Bison.
So at least we have to balance gud
yeah
tumoto so, nga ako silang gipasabot nga ang atong ang local source anato is nakadepende gud sa tourism.
Yes,
so most of tourism establishment
agli,
is wala gidron diba
affected magin sila yeah.
Yes so mo na at least na kasabot sila so we meet halfway.
Wow.
So nahuman na ang budget.
That is how important the role of the treasurers. You know, during this pandemic, yung mga tax base natin, yung taxpayer are hardly hit din. So baka ma-stress out din. But then again, sa executive side, they need to purchase more, to spend more, to combat COVID. Yun nga. So sabi ni Ma'am Pili, there is a need to balance and that is the heart of it all, the balancing. Now, what activities have you done, ma'am, in relation to COVID-19? Aside from the regular work as a treasurer, have you been called to participate in mga distribution, yung mga COVID programs, and ano pa dyan yung mga activities nyo, ma'am?
Yes, attorney. In fact, I am also a member of the crisis management team. So every day nag-meeting me at every 3 p.m. and nag-update kung unsa na yung sitwasyon sa Lapu-Lapu, pila nakabuok ang nagka-positive asa dapit niya area niya at least ang mga donations among gi-monitor and og asa sad gipang hatag
Lapu-Lapu City isolation center sad ma'am naa sad mo yung isolation center po COVID positive?
Yes, attorney. Ang atong City College utilize as an isolation center.
And subsidize, just like with Ma'am Carla, subsidize ang ilang food and everyday needs, ma'am?
Yes, yes, attorney.
Would you say, yeah. So, dako gyud kaayong role ang treasurer's office in terms of the purchases, pag continue continuing supply sa ato ang mga isolated patients.
Yes, attorney. So during the pandemic, wala jud mi na undang sa among trabaho.
So yeah, again, let's talk about that. Have you been on lockdown din yung office niyo during pandemic o continue tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung trabaho ng Treasurer's Office?
Actually, dun nag-lockdown gid diri ang city for 1 month, pero ang city treasurers nag-skeletal. Mostly sa amuang employees nga kanang mga senior na gyud nag-work at home sila for 1 month raman siguro, pero balik gid sila after ato.
So dito na tayo sa pero
gamay raman jud kayo nag-skeletal sa treasury.
Nag-skeletal kasi continue pa rin yung need to provide services. Dito na tayo sa innovations about COVID mitigation and prevention. What practices have you introduced doon sa office mo, ma'am, just to mitigate and prevent COVID transmission?
Actually, kaning online na to nga kuan. Online payment na po, attorney. Ako juning
assessment, online assessment. Ano na tayo niya, online payment. Okay, ma'am. Go ahead.
Yes, online payment o business taxes. So, kuli mahuman, makaraan na ni karong wapay second quarter nga deadline sa business tax. Kanya, in the coming, kung amo na pong gipa process karon ang online payment sa real property tax.
Ayan.
Ano kanindot good aning online payment sa real property tax kay bisan katong naa sa gawas ng mga taxpayer outside the Philippines, pwede sila mabayad. Yes. So, mauna amo ang ginatanaw nga mura ni diri sa ato ang system.
In your office, ma, at only sa staff mo, doon sa mga clientele mo rin, how do you enforce yung mga minimum health protocol? Lalo na yung mga social distancing. Ano yun, ma'am? Pag nagkukumpul-kumpul, sinasaway ba yan o rinirmay?
Yes, attorney. At least, ang most of our clients here na they are naa sa window na to. Labi na nang magkuha si Dula. Kunya magkuha lang mga resibo sa police clearance. Nya sa ato apong real property tax nasa tay mga window, pero naa man yung mga transactions nga kinahanglan gyud maatubang sa atong mga staff kay naa yung mga pamutana. So na at least na limit na lang ang fees. Nya naabot tay waiting area nga i-maintain po ang social distancing.
Social distancing pa rin.
Yes, kana pong atong entrance na kuy gi-set up dito sa mayor nga kanang naay sana mag-spray anang alcohol unya separate ang entrance. Okay. Nga separate po tong exit.
Exit one entrance, one exit regard.
Yes.
Okay. How about sa office mo, ma'am, yung pagkakain ng sabay-sabay, stricto ba kayo diyan o
hindi naman masyado kaming stricto doon, attorney, kaya lang yung tauhan natin mismo. Yun ang nag-ano na lang. Kanyang yung kain na lang.
So, in a range of 1 to 5, 1 being the most lenient and 5 the most strict, how would you rate yung sa implementation of minimum health protocol dyan sa office mo, ma'am?
Siguro nandun lang kami sa 4.
And why?
Kasi yung face shields, hindi pa masyadong ini-impose.
Yun yung nakakalimutan, medyo na hindi pa rin tayo sanay. Okay. In the event na mayroong COVID-19 positive dyan sa office niyo or mayroong considered close contact, ano yung standard protocol niyo dyan, Ma'am Fel?
Actually, attorney, doon na dyan yung nagka-positive sa amuang staff dere. O ba dyan ako? Pero may lang gani kay pagka matun nanay. Friday man to, so ni absent na lang siya dahil nag-isolate na siya sa iyang family. Dahil si Mayor po nagpa-disinfect dahil sa office na mo.
So mauna, disinfection and isolation to prevent. Now, at this juncture, Ma'am Fel, I'll give you the opportunity now to invite our FB page viewers at streamers live to vote Heart React for you sa ating search for the most outstanding treasurer amidst the pandemic. Go ahead, Ma'am Fel.
Calling all my friends there and those who want to let me win this most inspiring treasurer, please give me your heart. That's all. Ma'am Fel, thank you.
RD, Lapu-Lapu is a resort city. Ang daming kita sa nandito sa tourism. Pero ang tourism ministry is one of the affected. How hard would that be, RD, for a treasurer to work on something like that?
with the innovation that our treasurer is introducing in Lapu-Lapu, so I'm very positive that she can surpass the target. Mm-hmm. And with also the support of the mayor and Governor Gwen, who is really looking forward of opening the tourism industry in Cebu. So we're looking forward. Yes. In fact, kayo yung nagpa-package ng mga
tourism murang,
tour packages for
just to revive the economy, Ardi.
So the government now is helping the private sectors para ma-revive yung economy, especially sa tourism industry. So congratulations, Ma'am Ferry, for your time. And of course, looking forward for your more votes coming from Lapu-Lapu.
Ladies and gentlemen, yes, our fourth nominee for the most inspiring treasurer, Miss Felicitas Baguio, the City Treasurer of Lapu-Lapu City. Thank you, Ma'am Fer.
Thank you.
And I've learned something from that discussion. There is, aside from the balance of budget, yung collection at saka expenditure, balance din of, parang balance of being careful, staying safe, at saka balance of reviving the economy, kasi one of the badly hit industry is the tourism industry. Lapu-Lapu City. Congratulations, Ma'am Feli Baguio. And now, isang pasada muna before we get to the message of our regional director for the end of this episode. Sa mga sigaw palabas natin sa mga viewers dyan, pasok ni Jenna Nadelia.
Go, EL sa Kamatbat. Go, Ma'am Vilma Saldua. At pa rin ni Hardy Rest. Go, ikaw na, Ma'am Vilma. Congrats ga, Vilma Dimapi Saldua, ingon ni Elma Abrigo. Go, Carla Estrada. Aw. Ati Vilma Saldua, panindot og best practice, oy. Sabi ni Jana Diana Didit Talingting. At sabi ni Mirasol Trinidad, congrats, Miss V. And sabi ni Mr. Jeff Bahaw, City Assessor of Karkar City. Sir, shout out sa iyo, sir. Binabati kita ng isang sigaw palabas.
Sigaw palabas.
Para kay Jeff Bahaw. At saka kay...
Nakarating naman, sir. Nakarating. Salamat doon sa nakarating, sir.
At saka kay Engineer Julius Chin, the Municipal Assessor of Madrid, Dejos.
Spain.
Madrid, Spain. Yeah. Okay. Engineer Chin, good morning. Isang malakas na sigaw palabas. Okay, Torrance.
Thank you, Ms. Jonah Nabilia. Sigaw palabas din sa future Municipal Treasurer ng Borbon, Cebu. Ko ba i-mention basta future Municipal Treasurer. Ayan, pasadahan muna natin. Yes, Adi, go ahead, Adi.
Mag-update muna ako sa mga votes natin.
Oo nga. Sige, go ahead, pasok, Adi.
Yes, so I would like to update our viewers sa top 5 na mga highest voters with highest votes. Okay, we start with yung medyo nangunguna ngayon, si Assessor for the Assessment Group. Okay, so si Assessor number 4, medyo close, very very close tie. Okay, with 16.75%. Sumunod si Assessor number 2, okay, candidate number 2 with 16.09%. Sumunod si Assessor number 5 with 18%, very very close.
Okay.
Saka sumunod Assessor number 11 with 9.03%. At saka yung pang top 5 natin, si Assessor number 3 with 7.67%. So very close, very close po yung nabanan sa assessment group. Okay. And the rest, they occupy at the bottom side. Okay. Punta naman tayo sa treasurer. Okay, sa treasurer's group. Okay. Nangunguna si treasurer number 1, candidate number 1 with 30.60%. Sumunod si treasurer number 12 with 20.46%. Sumunod si treasurer number 13 with 9.13%. At saka si treasurer number 3 with 9.10%. At saka si treasurer number 3 with 9.10%. So, yun. So, for those who were not able to react hard the poster of our candidates, please help your bet for the most inspiring treasurer and assessor. Thank you, Tarns.
Thank you, Adi. Ang dami ng bumubuto, kaya isa siguro itong reason na nag-reach out, nag-susurpass na ng 100,000 yung reach at saka engagement time. Now aside, we forgot to tell you about this kasi, aside from voting hard, react doon sa mga nominees natin, paki-like naman yung page namin, baka naman. Paki-like naman, that is not a requirement pero sumusuyo naman kami sa inyo. Kasi during last week's engagement, medyo mataas ngayon hindi na sustain. So yung mga voters at saka mga nag-hack react dito sa ating mga nominees ngayon, i-like na rin ng Facebook page natin. Yan, ladies and gentlemen, pasadahan natin isang wave na lang sa ating mga hindi na lang natin pasalitain kasi time na. First nominee si Ma'am Marilu Herrera of Consolacion, Cebu. Gallery view please, production team, gallery view. Ayan, si Ma'am Marilu Herrera, first nominee, the assessors from Assessors Office of Consolacion. Second nominee, the Municipal Treasurer of San Remigio, Cebu, Ms. Edna Carla Arboyes. And the third nominee would be the Municipal Assessor of San Remigio pa rin, si Ms. Vilma Zaldua. At saka ating napaka-aktibo na Sete Treasurer ng Lapu-Lapu City, Ma'am Felicitas Bagyo. Wait, ma'am! Ladies and gentlemen, for the final message at closing message na rin, pasasalamat sa ating mga nominees at sa mga nagbo-vote. Original Director RD Doctolero, pasok RD.
Yes, so in behalf of the BNGF and your Alta family, we wish to thank our guest today, our finalists, Ma'am Vilma, Ma'am Feli, Ma'am Edna, Ma'am Malu, for graciously defending your title to become inspiring treasurer and assessor. Rest assured that many are looking at you to be their inspiration. Okay? So, alam ko na maraming nanonood sa atin, looking forward to at least pwede nilang i-duplicate or i-replicate what you have done in your respective LGUs. Thank you so much and good luck.
Thank you, Adi. And live from the Facebook page of BLGF7, this has been your host, Attorney Wilbert P. Tanyeka, in behalf of the production team, saying thank you and bye-bye.